Hi, how is it going? This is Dino Redwell here from Raqmedia.com. In today's tutorial, I will be showing you how to install WordPress script manually using FileZilla. Welcome back. So in order to install a WordPress script into your website manually, you need two things to start with. First of all, you're gonna need the WordPress zip file, which is this script. It can be downloaded from wordpress.org. And the second requirement is you're gonna need the file transfer protocol software, which is here we'll be using the FileZilla, which is one of the most recommended FTP softwares. The links will be provided below the videos or on our website. So after finishing the download process of WordPress script, next you right click on it and extract here. So just hit extract here. I have already extracted, so no need to re-extract again. Okay. Next you will have a folder like this one. This is the script that we'll be installing into our website. Great. That's it. Now we need to head on to our software, FileZilla. Here it is, portable edition. You can use the setup edition. Open it. And that's it. Here you need to provide your host. Next, your username, password, and the port, which is default 21 or 22. Next, you hit quick connect and it will be connected to your website remotely. As you can see here, we cannot install, should install the WordPress on the sub folder. Okay. Cannot be in here. That's it. What you're gonna do next is to head on to your search for the folder. I've seen that is in the desktop. That's it. So here you have a preview of all your files and folders in the selected folder. That's it. So what you're gonna do next is just select all the files and you just drag them into this part. As you can see, I have already dragged them or transferred them into my website. So you just drag them into this window and they will be uploaded, as you can see here. Successful transfers, 1909 files has been transferred, 0 file fails and queued 0. Great. So as you can see, our website now has been loaded with the script. Let's head on now to our website. First of all, before you start installing the script, head on to MySQL database in order to create a database first. Click on it. Next, you will have a new page in which you have the ability to create a new database and to select the name of it as you like. These databases are meant to store the information of your website. So, as you can see here, just write the name of the database. Should remember it, of course, to be used later in the setup. So, write your database name. and hit next create, and it will be created as the one you see in here, which we have created before. Great. After finishing creating the database, you turn back and just save the username and the password in order to be used later, and you go back. Now let's head on to our website and refresh it in order to get the, so as you can see, this the screen or the homepage that you will get when you install the script into your website. So this means WordPress has been installed successfully, and this is the front page. Let's select the language, United States. Great. Continue. Can see the address is in here. If you face any problem, just type in wp-admin/setup-config-php and to wait a few seconds, as this is the first time. Well done. Okay, so here we need to set up the configuration. For getting started, we need some information on the database. You will need to know the following item before proceeding: database name, database username, password, host, table prefix. If you want to run more than one WordPress in a single database, we are going to use the information to create a wp-config-php file. For any reason, this automatic creation doesn't work, etc. So we're gonna need the information that we have saved before. Let's hit, let's go. Great. Wait a few seconds. Let's be patient. Well done. Okay, so as you can see here, we have the database name, the username, the password, and database host. All these four things must be changed, and we must keep the last one default WP. Let's go back to our database. So what you're gonna do next is just changing your database name in here, your username and password, and leave the rest for database host. It will be your local host, and the last one, which will be default also. So we'll keep the two last one. So we'll change the first three boxes and keep the rest as default. Let's do it. So first you have your username. Next, first you have your database name. Next, your username. And at last, the password. Let's paste it and click on submit. Wait a few seconds, it's loading as you can see.
www.raqmedia.com.
To try again, maybe the password is incorrect. Yeah, password is incorrect, so let me check again. Next, we just enter in your password and leave the rest as we said. So let's hit submit and wait a few seconds. One of this information is not correct, or the password is not the right one, then you will receive an error message. So as you can see here, we need to inject the password and the username and database name into the WP config PHP. So we need to make some adjustment into the files of the WordPress script first. So we'll show you how to do it first before we try again. So as we said, we need to go back to the WordPress file, head on to WP config sample that you'll find in here, PHP. What you're gonna do is rename it wp-config-php, just delete sample and save. Next, right click on it and edit with notepad. Great. So as you can see here, we have, if you go back to the bottom, MySQL settings, and you find the database name, username, password, host, chart, etc. So what you need to change is are the three things that you have changed into the setup website. So just copy them. Next, you just hit save. And that's it. It's finished. Next, we need to reconnect to FileZilla in order to upload the file that we have updated. So click your docs, where you have transferred the files. You can see, search for them in here. That's the file. So we're gonna upload the new file that we have updated, which is this one. Refresh and head on to your, to where you have WP, this one. So just drag it and drop it here. I see it has been transferred successfully. Great. Let's go back now to our website panel and check again. Paste in the password and submit. Voila, so as you can see, it's all done correctly and your script has been installed successfully. So let's run the installation. Well done. Okay, so that's the first step in which you will be asked to provide a site for your site name or title, your username, your password and your email in order to log in into WordPress. Can change the site name later. So Raq shop. Okay, so after finishing your site title, username, your password must be a strong one, and your email with which you will log in into your dashboard. At the bottom here, if you do not intend to use your website for search engine, then you just discourage search engine from indexing the site by checking this box. That's it. So next you click on install WordPress. Save your passwords. Well done. Okay, congratulations. So your WordPress script has been installed successfully. Let's log in. Well done. So as you can see, it's been saved. So now need to retype it again. And next, you, if you want to be remembered, then check remember me or click on log in. Let's log in and check. And voila, so that's it. Congratulations, you have reached the final stage on our installation, which is the dashboard of WordPress. Everything is going right and you have your WordPress installed properly, loaded with the minimum features and options. I need to go through the different features in here in order to make a great website. Okay, with this we have finished our tutorial of WordPress installation. Keep tuned for coming tutorials on how to get the most of WordPress and how to install WooCommerce and Shopify onto your site and increase your revenues. Peace. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, do consider sharing it. Click on the like button and go ahead and leave us a comment below. We'd love to hear from you, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and the notifications to get the latest tutorials that will inspire, empower, and connect you.
www.raqmedia.com
Bye for now, see you next video.